Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome you all to learn Chinese language with Chinese Language Made Easy. I'm Muhammad Shahid and today I'm going to talk about some key verbs used in Chinese language. Mera naam Muhammad Shahid hai aur aaj main kuch chini zuban ke afaal ke bare mein baat karne ja raha hu jo ke aap istemal kar sakte hain kisi bhi waqt चीनी किसी भी चीनी शख्स के साथ رابطہ करने के लिए या वैसे भी अगर आपने चीनी जुबान का इस्तेमाल करना हो तो आपको इन अफाल के बारे में अगर पता हो तो शायद आपकी कुछ मुश्किल आसान हो जाए तो मेरे साथ आखिर तक रहिए और हम इंशाल्लाह आज कुछ हो सकता है कि आप सीख चुके हो पहले ही लेकिन अगर नहीं सीखे हो तो कुछ नया सीखने को आपको मिल जाएगा तो चलिए आगे चलते हैं और इसके बारे में आगे जानते हैं कि हम आज क्या सीखने वाले हैं सो लेट्स जस्ट गेट स्टार्टेड विद आवर टुडेज लेक्चर अबाउट दोज की वर्ब्स इन चाइनीज लैंग्वेज लेट मी टेल यू आई हैव मेड सम सेंटेंसेस ओवर दोज वर्ब्स सो इट विल मेक इट इजियर फॉर यू टू यूज इट इन योर सेंटेंसेस ओके सो द फर्स्ट वर्ब विद अस सी वन See, one, to like, pasand karna. Pehla jo fail hai, chini zuban ka, wo hai, see, one, to like, see, one, to like. Okay? So, ni si huan ni de lao shi ma. The sentence is, ni si huan ni de lao shi ma. Do you like your teacher? Kya tum apne ustad ko, ya ustani ko, पसंद करते हो तो सी ह्वान मींस टू लाइक सो पसंद करना नी मींस यू सी ह्वान मींस टू लाइक नी द योर लाओ शि टीचर मा इज सच अ पार्टिकल यूज्ड इन अ सेंटेंस दैट मेक अ सेंटेंस इंटरोगेटिव सो इट सेज डू यू लाइक योर टीचर क्या तुम अपने उस्ताद को या उस्तानी को पसंद करते हो Ni si huan ni de lao shi ma. So this is about the first verb which we had learned today. Si huan pasand karna. Okay? I am going to tell you about the individual meaning of each and every word. So the words will not be very hard for you to learn. So let's just proceed to the next slide and get to know the next word. So this is thing to listen thing wo fail hai jiska matlab hai sunna so I have written a sentence over here and it says wo thing bu dong okay so it says I don't understand So, native speakers use this sentence a lot. And when do they use this? Okay. When do they use this sentence? So, it is a sentence which they use in a situation. I mean, if they listen to something and they do not understand it, so they can say, 我听不懂, I don't understand. मुझे समझ नहीं आई चीनी लोग इस जुमले का इस्तेमाल तब करते हैं जब उन्हें लगता है कि कोई बोल रहा है और उन्हें सुनाई दे रहा है लेकिन वो समझ नहीं पा रहे जो वो बंदा या जो वो शख्स कहना चाह रहा है तो इस मौके पर वो कहते हैं वो थिंग पू दोंग आई डोंट अंडरस्टैंड मुझे समझ नहीं आया या मुझे समझ नहीं आई कि आप क्या कहना चाह रहे हैं सो ये ऐसे मौकों पर इस्तेमाल करते हैं और ये ज्यादातर जो नेटिव स्पीकर्स है चीनी जबान के जिन लोगों की जबान है तो वो इसको इस्तेमाल करते हैं सो दिस इज अबाउट द सेकेंड वर्ड वी आर गोइंग टू नो अबाउट द थर्ड वर्ड टुडे एंड इट इज सीवी दिस इज द कैरेक्टर इट मीन्स टू वॉश धोना तो This is the sentence, fan qian xi shou. Fan means meal, kana. Qian means pehle. Xi means to wash. So fan means mil, qian means before, xi means to wash, shao means hand. So wash, mil before wash hands. The literal meaning of this sentence is mil before wash hands. Fan qian xi shou, fan qian xi shou, fan qian xi shou. So this is how we are going to say. Now you will ask that where is the you in this sentence, that you are saying that wash your hands before meals. Khane se pehle apne haath dhoye. Okay, so wash your hands before meals is we will know about the listener, the receiver of about the receiver who we are talking to. We know that person. So, because we know that we are addressing that person, so that is why, and even in English sentences, you will find a lot of sentences where you will omit the one who you address. Like in imperative sentences, you will say, sit down. Now, the one who you are talking to is already known. That is why you're not using you sit down. You just say sit down. So, fan qian xi shou, wash your hands before meals. Kani se pehle haath dhoye. To ye maine aapko bata diya. Fan means kana, qian means pehle, xi means dhona, shou haath. To kani se pehle apne haath dhoye. This is about the third verb. Now the fourth verb is xiu xi, xiu xi, xiu xi means to rest, aram karna. Ni kui xiu xi yi huar, ni kui xiu xi yi huar, ni kui xiu xi yi huar. You can have a rest for a while. Tum thodi der aram kar sakte ho. Ni means you, kui can, xiu xi to rest, yi huar for a while, for a little while. So you can have a rest for a little while. Tum thodi der ke liye aram kar sakte ho. This is about the fourth verb. Xiu xi means to rest, aram karna. Tum thodi der ke liye aram kar sakte ho. So this is about the fourth verb. Now the last verb in today's video is gao su means to tell, batana. Ni wei shenme bu gaosu wo ni shu shu de si. Ni wei shenme bu gaosu wo ni shu shu de si. So this is the verb number fifth, which we are going to talk about. This is gao su to tell, batana. Gao su, ni wei shenme bu gaosu wo ni shu shu de si. Ni wei shenme bu gaosu wo ni shu shu de si. Okay, here N is missing. S, H, E, and N. Here, N is missing. So, you just have to know about this, that one word is missing over here in, because it's shama. Ni wei shama bu gao su wo. Ni means you, wei shama, why? Bu gao su, didn't tell. Wo, here, it means me. Ni shu shu de si. Ni means here this wa is used is me. Okay, why didn't you tell me? Ni shu shu da, your uncles. Okay, your uncles. Ni shu shu da means your uncles. Sa, death. Why didn't you tell me about your uncles' death? Tumne mujhe apne chacha ke wafat ke bare mein kyun nahi bataya? So remember that shushu means younger brother of your father. Abbu ke chote bhai ko shushu kehte. In Chinese, they differentiate it. So why didn't you tell me about your uncle's death? Ni wei shenme bu gaosu wo ni shushu de si? Tumne mujhe apne chacha ki wafat ke bare mein kyun nahi bataya? So this was all for today. I hope that you would have liked today's lecture. And if you like these video lectures, don't forget to subscribe to Chinese Language Made Easy and share it with your friends as much as you can. We are going to meet each other in next lecture, inshallah. ہم اگلے لیکچر ویڈیو لیکچر انشاءاللہ ملیں گے. تب تک کے لیے اللہ حافظ. سائچین.